being led by prophets. They were led by prophets. Their leaders was their prophets. So, anytime, kullama halaka nabiyan, at any time that they will kill a prophet, shuf, any time that they will kill a prophet, khalafahu nabiyan, any time that they kill a prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replace it with another prophet. Their prophet were their leaders. Any time that they will kill a prophet, Allahu Jalla Ala will replace it with another prophet. And this was the ways of barakallahu fikum the Banu Israel. Right? Killing their prophets alayhim salatu wasalam. Right? So, wa innahu la nabiyyi la nabiyya ba'di. Wa innahu la nabiyya ba'di. Shuf. He said, but indeed there is no prophet after me. There is no prophet after me. Right? You heard that. There is no prophet after me. He say, وَسَتَكُونُ خُلَفَاءَ. He say, it will be many khalifas. It will be many khalifas. Many khalifas. Many leaders. Not prophets, but many leaders. قالوا the Sahaba رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين, they say, وما تأمرنا, what is it that you advise us, O Messenger of Allah? Shuft, any time that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he talks about important matters, right? In all of the important matters that he talks about, the companion they always ask about, what is the way out of that? What is the way? Because here you have Al-Anbiya. It is not an issue because the way they do things is by what? Wahyu. It's by way of revelation. It's by way of revelation. Barakallahu fikum. But amma the khulafa, there is no wahyu after that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed. There is no more wahyu coming after the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed. No more wahyu after the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Right, except for the who, they got those that have they still they have wahyu in the bizamihim. Bizamihim, yes. When I say bizamihim, you should understand. Ahsanta, like the Sufi, for them they still receiving wahyu. Right, they say what? Mada yaqulun? What do they say? What do the Sufi say? They say, حدثني قلبي. حدثني قلبي. My heart has revealed to me. Right? So for them, they still receive revelation. But it is no revelation but the whispers of the shaitan. It is no revelation but the whispers of the shaitan. But the whispers of the shaitan that they hear. That their hearts is referring to them. So they say, وَمَا تَأْمُرُنَا, and what is it that, Ya Rasool Allah, that you advise us? قَالُوا, أو قَالَ, the messenger say. He say, فُو بِبَيْعَتِ. He say, fulfill. Obey. The first one that you gave the bay'ah. The first one you gave the bay'ah, obey him. وَأَطِيعُوا. Right, the first one you gave the bay'ah, you give him the, you obey him. The first one you gave the bay'ah, you obey him. And likewise, wa'atuhum haqqahum, and give them their rights. Give them their rights. Obey the one that you give the bay'ah, and give them their rights. For indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them amma istar'ahum, that which he has placed under their responsibility. Allah will ask them of their responsibility yawm al-qiyamati. You give them their rights. And what is the right of the leader? As-sam'u wa ta'a. Give them their rights. Obey them. Give them their rights. And from the rights of the leader, barakallahu fikum, many as we will cover that, inshallah ta'ala, in the next few chapter coming. Give them their rights. Give them their rights. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them about what He has placed under their on their shoulders. The responsibility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them, He will ask them about it yawm al-qiyamati. Shaykh Rabi Hafidhullah, he say, Kayfa inna Allah, he say, how is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them in regard to the responsibility that He given them? He say, look, the messenger, ma qala, he did not say, Hafidhullah, hasibuhum, that put them into accountability. Check their works. Be the check and balance in regard to the leaders. The messenger did not say that. He didn't say have a commission that is to supervise the work of the leaders. To be looking into the details of the work of the leader. He didn't say that. He didn't say hasibuhum, put them into check. He didn't say that. But rather he say what? He say obey them and give them their rights. For Allah will ask them about their responsibility. Allah will ask them about what He has placed on their shoulders. Now here it is a matter, barakallahu feekum, that akhi, very few of the people today, they are upon this manhaj. I mean, throughout the earth, very few of the people, you will find them, when it comes to the Muslim ruler, they want to implement, they want to apply, tatbiq, they want to implement, they want to apply that which, alhamdulillah, is from the matters of the aqeedah. They will not go by way of, this and the third. But rather they will go by what the Sharia has established for them. What did the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said? The same way that we pray, how the Messenger prayed. The same way that we, barakallahu fikum, fast as the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam fasted. The same way that we will perform the pilgrimage in the Hajj. The same way we are taking it from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But we memorize those hadith. خُذُوا عَنِّي مَنَاسِكَكُمْ, take from me your Hajj rituals. صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِي أُصَلِّي. We don't have no problem when it comes to these issues. But now when it comes about the ruler, about somebody taking our wealth and breaking our backs, akhi, you have to be upon pure Salafiyya. Upon pure Salafiyya, not upon a claim, to be, barakallahu feekum, able to sustain that. To be able to, barakallahu feekum, have forbearance in regard to that and in regard to implementing what? The legislation of Allah. As we have mentioned that as-sabra, kam anwa'a? Thalatha, na'am, number one. Sabr in regard to obedience of Allah. Sabr in regard to having ikhlas, number one. While you doing it, the action. Making sure that, barakallahu feekum, you are, while you're doing the action, making sure you're doing it upon the Sharia. And number three, after the action, you will safeguard your action from anything that will yubtiluhu, that will destroy it. This is the sabr ala ta'atillah. Sabr upon the obedience of Allah. So here it requires a great amount of what? A great amount of patience. To be able to withhold yourself in this musibah of having a leader that is not doing you right. But not only you're going to be patient, but akhi, you have to make dua for him. That's difficult, ain't it? Akhi, think about somebody taking your wealth, right? Beating your back. أَخَذَ مَالَكَ وَضَرَبَ ظَهْرَكَ. He take your wealth and he beat your back for you to turn around and say, oh Allah, rectify his affairs. Oh Allah, make his matters easy. Because if his matters are easy, then he will not strike nobody else back. He will not take no one else's money. Now this requires a great amount of patience. Shaykh Rabi Hafidhullah, he say, look, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ma qala, he did not say hasibuhum. He did not say put them into account. He did not say thuru, that revolt and rebel alayhim, against them. Ukhruju, and he revolt against him. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he didn't say this. He didn't say khudhu haqqakum, take your rights with your own hands. He didn't say that. Allah
Quran.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Shaykh Rabi, went to say, he say, the messenger did not say revolt against those rulers. He didn't say rebel against them. He didn't say also just put them into account. He didn't say ukhruju, revolt against them. He didn't say khudu haqqakum. He didn't say take your rights. He say li'anna ba'du thuriyin. من كبائر هؤلاء من كبار هؤلاء الثوريين يقولوا. He said that some of these individuals from the rebels or from those who are revolting against the ruler, he said from the elite ones, meaning from their chiefs and from their heads, they will say this statement. He said, ما تنتظر الفرج يأتينا من السماء. Al-Faraj ya'tina min as-sama ma'dhira. He say that it is not that we're going to be waiting. Do not wait for the salvation or for the success or the rectification to come, to be falling from the sama, from the sky. Don't wait for the faraj to be just falling down from the heavens. Don't think that barakallahu fikum, the situation going to just fall, the solution will fall from the sky. Don't think that the solution will just fall from the sky just like this. This is what they will say. And these are statements, barakallahu fikum. If it falls into the wrong ears, it's a big problem. Because this is the true situation. Right? The rectification will not just come out. People, barakallahu fikum, they have to, barakallahu fikum, do that which they have to do of what is right. Right? And they will be even sometime quoting these verses. Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma bi anfusikum. Biqawmin. Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin. Hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusikum. That Allah will not rectify that which, meaning a people, except that themselves they rectify that which is within themselves. Now they will utilize the likes of these verses. And not barakallahu fikum being able to distinguish what is this verse talking about. Is this verse talking about get up, take the weapon and go fight for your life? Get up and fight for your life. Get up and fight for your dues. It is not saying that barakallahu fik. It is not saying none of those barakallahu fik. So he mentioned that these present days from the kibar, from their leaders, from their heads, from their elites, that they will say, we will not wait for the success or for the ease or for the outcome to be coming from the sama. La budda an na'khudh haqqana bi aydina. We must be taking our rights with our own hands. We must take our dues with our own hands. We must take our dues with our own hands. Now, when you hear people talking like this, akhi, know that they are straight up, raw, uncut, unaltered khawarij. Like we gotta take what is for us.